Hey guys, good evening. How are all of you doing? Today we come to the 13th part of our phrasal verbs, master phrasal verbs. Okay, this is Bobby Yadav and I have taught for various common written exams like MAT, PCT banking exams as well as CAT, which is my forte. And I have over a decade's teaching experience in these common written exams and worked in several renowned institutions before I joined an academy. Please subscribe to hashtag cat live. I repeat guys, please subscribe to hashtag cat live daily. You will be able to get the notification of the classes then. Okay, then we come to the Telegram channel. Please download it ASAP and click on the URL livedaily.me/chat and look for an academy cat. Here you will be able to download the PDFs. Guys, coming to the an academy subscription, it's very, very pocket friendly. Good evening, Urvashi. Very, very pocket friendly. 1 month it is just 3,500. 3 months 2,917. 6 months 2,333. 12 months 1,458, and 24 months just 875. So if you are a 12 months a 2021 aspirant, please go for the 12 month subscription. And if you are a 2022 aspirant, please go for the 24 month subscription. You can apply my referral code BYLIVE and get 10% discount. Great guys, let's move on. So these are the upcoming batches for the month of January. On 11 January, we are starting a weekday batch for 2021. That will be an evening batch. Then from 12th of January, there'll be the Achievers batch, which will be the GD, WAT and PI sessions in the evening. And then we have an Absolute batch for MASET, and that is starting on the 13th of January. Great. Let's move on to the next one. So guys, talking about the Unacademy Combat. Now this is a fortnightly competition for CAT. So here you get to face several challenging questions, which is created by the best of educators, and you get to compete with the best, and detailed video solution will be available to you by the top educators. The next combat is scheduled on the 10th of January from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Please register now. In order to unlock, you can use my referral code BYLIVE. And guys, Rushikesh sir is going to have an interview about how to enhance your knowledge. That is on 7 January 4 p.m. Okay, that you can attend. Okay guys, coming to master phrasal verbs, part 13. Are you all ready? Who all are here guys? Who are the students who are here for the session? Urvashi is here. Other than that, let's say a quick hi and then we can get started. Yes guys, who all are here? Nobody seems to answer. Okay, let's get started. This is the first one coming up. Okay, you have the word kick. Please go through the options and tell me which one is incorrect? Which sentence is incorrect? Hi Rohit, hi Ranjan. Welcome to the session. This is the first word which has come up. Please identify the sentence which is wrong. Hi Zaka. Good evening to all of you. Hi Raki. Hi, Charu. Okay, so let me wait for some more answers to come in. Good evening, Akshay. How are you? Rakhi is saying, see. Okay, guys, now. Yeah, all of you, Charu, Urvashi, Ranjan, you people are right. This is wrong. See, the budget cuts are starting to kick about. Kick about is wrong. What should be used instead of kick about? It should be kick in. It should be kick in. Kick in means to come into effect. That is to kick in. The budget cuts are starting to kick in and people are struggling. So actually kick about means to discuss. And to discuss doesn't fit in here. Yeah. Did all of you follow, guys? Rakhi, you chose C, right? Did you follow? Yeah. So see, I'll kick the dog. This is correct. The police kicked the door. Kick the door is also correct. Children love to kick the ball. That is also correct. As is literally hitting with your leg, right? That is kicking. So why not? Why did you all choose C? The police can't actually hit the door with the leg, right? With one of your feet. Okay, fine. We'll move on to the next question. Tune. Go in for the next one. So the answers are coming in. Sebin says C. Urvashi C. Rakhi Chug C. Charu says D. Okay, answer. Keep answering, guys. Okay, guys, now C is the correct answer. Akshay, A. See, I had just tuned into a TV show. Tuned in means to connect. Yeah? So I just love this tune. This tune is with reference to music, right? Then tuned out is wrong, right? He's tuned out his car. Tuned out means what you know. Tuned out means to ignore. Tuned out means to ignore. So what will be your correct preposition here? It should be tuned up. Tuned up means what? Tuned up would mean to improve. To improve the performance. So what is it saying? He is tuned up his car. That is, he has actually made his car ready for the rest to improve the performance, right? So your answer is C. You can use had just. What is the problem with just there? No problem. Make sure you tune into next week's show. Is make sure you connect to the next week's show. Again, you connect yourself to the next week's show. So that is also correct. This is correct. This is correct. This is correct. C is wrong. Did all of you follow? Yes, guys, is it clear? Okay, I'm moving on to the next one. Lo, did all of you follow, guys? Any doubts? Yes, Aishik, you're a little late. Anyway, nevertheless, we are in the third phrasal verb. Do watch the recording for the rest, okay? Ma'am, last sentence, nahi samajh aaya. Which one? The second one, Charu? Make sure you tune into next week's show. Now, suppose you're watching a serial. Okay, suppose you're watching the Kapil Sharma show. Okay, so if I tell you, make sure you tune into next week's show, that means make sure you connect. You watch the next week's show. It can be to connect or to watch. Did you follow, Charu? Okay, so the third one, guys. Okay, guys, for the third one, yes, the third one, B is wrong. What is blowing it up means? Blowing it up means to explode, right? Blow up is to explode. But here, what is it trying to say? The sentence is trying to say that I couldn't light the campfire. The wind kept. What should you use? Thank you, Bineet. So what will it be? Blow it out. So this up is wrong. Blow up is to explode. This is to explode, right? But blow it out means, it means to extinguish. So the wind kept extinguishing the campfire, right? Correct, Ranjan. You are right. So, blow out should be the answer here. So, up is wrong here. It should be out. Blowing it out. Okay, blow up means to explode. Now, my parents blew up when they found me smoking means my parents got very angry. Angry, you can say exploded also. Exploded with anger. Okay, now the window blew the smoke back down the chimney because of the heavy wind. It blew the smoke back down the chimney. That is fine. So sorry, this is the wrong one, incorrect one. This is correct. This is correct to blow a balloon, that you know, right? Will blowing it up. No, so blowing it up would be explode, to explode, na? They were thinking of blowing it up. Right, Aishik? Blowing it up means they were thinking of exploding something. Is it clear, guys? Aishik, is it clear? Okay, can we move on to the next question? Come. Yeah, blowing it out is also correct. See these phrasal verbs, na? You can introduce a pronoun. There is no problem. I will get you certain, in near future, I will get you certain phrasal verbs wherein you got to introduce a pronoun or change the tense. No problem. So, I have Sarveshwari and Ranjan already answering. So, Sarveshwari and Ranjan says B, Urvashi says D. Aishik says B, Seven says B. D. Okay, guys, the answer is B. This is wrong. B is wrong. They come up as very rude. What do you mean by come up? Can you tell me what will be the correct phrasal verb here? The students who have chosen B, can you tell me what is the correct phrasal verb? No, it is not D. It is B only. Charvi, Kishan, Sebin, Aishik, you are correct. Akshay, can you tell me what is the correction here? What is the correction? Not came up, no. Come up and came up mein fark hi kya hai, Kishan? Kali tense structure alag hai na? No, it is come across. They come across. They come across means they seem very rude. They come across, they project themselves as very rude. Okay, it is come across, not come up. Now look at the first one. I just knew the manager would come and solve the problem. This is correct. He would come and mediate, come and solve the problem. Here basically it means he would mediate and solve the problem, right? Then C is no one can come up with a good advertisement. What do you mean come up with a good advertisement? Come up with means to think of a good plan, to think of something good. Okay, and then Bob has come up. Now suppose a person, ma'am, in D, we should use came with has as came in the third form of verb. My dear Urvashi, what is the question? I mean, sorry, the sentence. Bob has come up. Now, what do you mean has come up? Like maybe he was in the ground floor. He has come up to the terrace with a welding torch and some scrap iron. What is wrong with that? Come up with, what is wrong? He has come up, that means a level higher. Did you get my point? He has come up with a welding torch and some scrap iron. Did you follow, guys, all of you? It can be like, you know, he can come up, right? Did all of you follow? So that there's nothing wrong in this. Even this is correct. This is correct. This is correct. B is wrong. Fine. Let's move on to the next one. Stop. So 7 says D. Ranjan say 7 says D. Aishik says C. Ranjan says B. Sarveshwari C. Akshay says C. Guys, the incorrect sentence is D. Seven, you're right. The answer is D. You don't say stop in. You say stop by. Stop by means to visit. Okay. Stop in, guys. Stop in means not to go, to stay home. So the answer is D, guys. Aishik, it is D. Now look at the first one. After the terrorist attacks on London, tourists stopped coming for a while. That is correct, right? Now I didn't have time to talk, so I told him to stop back later. Stop back later means return. So stop back is correct. Stop back is correct. Okay. Then we, it is not stop of my, it is stop by for D. Then when you come to option C, I stopped behind after the meeting to talk to Bill. So what does it mean? I stayed back. I stayed back. Yeah, I stayed back after the meeting to talk to Bill. Did all of you follow, guys? Here, okay. I have the next one coming up. The next one, and this is the last one, guys. Sarveshwari says A, okay. Yes, guys, answer quickly. Mehi says A. Seven A. All of you are saying A, is it? Okay, so guys, is A because you sorry, this is incorrect because you say hang up your jacket. Hang up as in you hang your jacket, right? Whereas when you talk about hang out means what? To stay in a place to have fun. Okay, now what are you doing? I am just hanging out. Hanging out means spending time with someone. Okay, so this is correct. Don't hang up. Don't hang up means what? Don't disconnect. I'm going to change my phones, right? Then Maria and Freya usually hang around. What does hang around means? Basically, hang around means what? To loaf idly, just to loaf about without any purpose. To loaf idly. Right, guys? Yeah? Okay. So thank you so much for joining me in this session, and we are going to wind up now. So I hope this session is benefiting you guys. I would definitely want a feedback from you because these phrasal verbs are not easy. At the same time, you must have good knowledge of it, right? Thank you so much, guys. And do like and share. Do not forget to like and share, guys. Do not forget to like and share because it will benefit a lot of students. And so these are the upcoming batches, guys. 11th January, we are starting a weekday evening batch. Then 12th January, we have the Achievers batch for the GD, WAT and PI sessions. And then 13th January, we have the Absolute batch for Marset starting. Then the Unacademy Combat, guys, very, very important. It is a fortnightly competition wherein you can compete with the best and face challenging CAT questions created by the best of educators. Then you will also get a detailed solution by the top educators. So the enrollment is free, guys. Please register for it. It is on the 10th of January, 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. And you to unlock, you can use BYLIVE. Right, my referral code. And Rushikesh sir is going to have an interview session about how to enhance your knowledge, and that will be on January 7th, 4 p.m. And I have already started a course to master VARC on January 4th. So we are still doing the basics. You can take a subscription and join in, guys. The classes are from Monday to Friday, 8:15 to 9:15. Use my referral code BYLIVE and you'll get 10% discount. And the verbal ability session is started by Harpreet ma'am and in the morning at 9:30 a.m. And then I start the session at 7 p.m. Guys, today we are having reading comprehension practice exercise. To do join me at 7 p.m. in the evening on Unacademy CAT, followed by quantitative ability. Amit sir takes from 8 to 9, LRDI by Asis sir, 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. And again, quantitative ability by Pratik sir from 10 p.m. to 11 p.m. So do subscribe to hashtag CAT Live Daily, and you will be able to get the updates about the classes. And talking about the Telegram channel, guys, please download it and click on the URL livedaily.me/chat and look for Unacademy CAT. You will download the PDF from here. The subscriptions, guys, very, very important. You get to attend live classes. You can interact with us on a daily basis. The test series, which is very, very important, is included in your subscribed course, and we provide plenty of practice sessions to you. Okay, and every fourth class is a doubt clearing session. So please do join, guys. And you just have to go to Play Store, download the Unacademy Learning app, and install. That's it. And look for the Plus platform. Your goal is CAT. You will find more than 30 hours of sessions happening every day. And these sessions are available in English as well as Hindi. And more than 14 top educators will be there to help you out. So get your subscriptions today, guys. If you are a 2021 aspirant, go for the 12-month subscription, which is just $14.58 per month. And if you are a 2022 aspirant, it is 24 months. You can take the subscription for 24 months, which is just $8.75 per month. Do use my referral code BYLIVE and you can get 10% discount. Do like and share, guys. Do not forget to like and share before you leave. And subscribe to hashtag CAT Live Daily. And it's not only CAT, you have NEET, JEE, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, everything available at an academy. And last but not the least, my referral code BYLIVE and avail 10% discount. I'll see you at 7 p.m. sharp, okay, with RC practice exercise. Thank you. Bye-bye. Have